stacks on deck, Patron on ice. We can pop bottles all night, baby. You can have whatever you like. Yeah, you can have whatever you like. Yeah, late night sex, so wet, so tight. Gas up the jet for you tonight, baby. You can go wherever you like. Yeah, you can go wherever you like.
Pastor in Wellington, and he'll be assisting me today. There's really good instructions on the invitations about photos, where to share them and where not to share them. Okay, I think you know what I mean. Okay, get them to be the first ones to share them to the world. And let's turn our phones off.
In the name of Jesus Christ, the one who has called us here together to be a blessing of this time. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, send your Holy Spirit in and among us all so that you equip us well to be a blessing to this couple. So that the blessing is enduring and lasting for all their life. Pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So, Socrates said, if you marry a good wife, you'll be very, very happy. If you marry a bad wife, he said, you'll become a philosopher and you'll also be very, very happy. With that, I'd like to call Victoria to read our reading.
Yes. Chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. Two are better than one because they have a good return on their work. If one falls down, the other can help them up. But pity the one who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defeat themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. This is the word of the Lord.
Jesus surely could pull any kind of girl. One like Stephanie, maybe? What would Jesus' bride be like? The Bible gives a picture of Jesus' bride. Okay? I don't know what you might be thinking, but it's not really nice. Just a reflection on your book. Jesus' bride is really, really dodgy.
And somewhere else.
But this,
and how would you deal with a relationship like that? Your bride or your groom is absolutely dodgy. And gave himself up for her, making her holy, cleansing her by washing her with words, and then presenting her to himself as radiant, without stain, without wrinkle, no blemishes, but holy and blameless. Overpowered, but two can help defend each other. It sounds really good. Whoever wrote this has got a nice rhythm going, two, two, two. And then in the last line they mess it up by saying, a cord of three strands is not easily broken. What's this three all of a sudden? And I really believe that three, oh, it's too simple to say, it's a cliche, although that's God. But what I'm saying, the third strand, you've come all the way from Australia and from all over New Zealand and other places to be here, and you're in your best clothes, fantastic, and we're not just here for a good time.
I ask you, Christian Aitken Hamilton, will you have Stephanie Rhiannon Flitton as your wife to live together as God has ordained, state of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both will live? You have Christian Aitken Hamilton as your husband. Live together. God has ordained the state of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Now join your hands and exchange your vows. Before God and in the presence of us all, I, as a servant of God, by the authority of the nation of New Zealand, declare them to be husband and wife. Thank you. Father, we've conducted this wedding under your eyes, with your blessing, with your promises. So we pray for Christian and Stephanie. We pray that their marriage is long, happy, joyful and fruitful. We pray too that these people here and their other friends, Father, in the name of Jesus, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Give us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We give you power. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit bless you and enrich your marriage. May He watch over your marriage.
Thank you.